Have you tried BAT and CAT? Why are some trainers so adamant that it's the best way to resolve aggression and some could care less about it? Thoughts?
Probably because it works for them. So what we do is probably similar to BAT, we just don't have acronyms. So historically, BAT takes a really long time. But the best way to do all this stuff is try it yourself. Have you seen the book on BAT, the protocols that you have to do for BAT? So what we do, I mean, remote collar can eliminate BAT. But we stop the unwanted behavior, and then we reward the wanted behavior. We use distance. We this concept of keeping dogs always under threshold, we don't do that. If anything, we push dogs past threshold because there's something out there called life, right? There's something out there called life. We want dogs to know how to behave in a crazy world, and especially in an unpredictable world. So, but what I tell people is we've had many clients that have been tried BAT, and then in one session with us, they made more progress. And they've been on doing BAT for 12 months. But it's possible they did BAT wrong. But I've seen the book. The protocol is pretty extreme. But that might have just been from one trainer. So I can't give you an expert opinion because I have never tried it. But I've heard enough about it that I know that what we do is along the similar concept, but just more quicker and effective. Next. Oh, going live. Now we're live. Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and hey Francis, I you found the show. Yeah, so sorry about that, guys. So it looks like we don't, I didn't put the comments on in time.
Don't worry about me. You okay. Just keep talking.
Right.
I'm just going to find it.
Hi everybody, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and this is our Q&A show. It's the second Q&A show of the night. I forgot to turn the, I pressed go play without any comments, and you can't do anything once you're there. I think one time I figured out how to do that, but I forgot, and I should, like, I would.
Forgot.
I should stop doing it.
Well, so here we are.
Well, I load the show up in the morning, and I don't want people will write comments all day long,
right?
And then leave and then never attend the show, and it's not fair to the people that actually are attending the show live,
right?
So that's not fair to them. So that's why I do it. But it's a Q&A show. It's a 90-minute show, and a lot of people, you know, ask questions. How do you stop bad behavior? So you hear me talk about punishment, the application of punishment. You can't reward a dog out of a bad behavior, and the industry is just lying to you. Our industry, even my balanced community here, is getting worse and worse and worse, more hateful. It's almost child. It's just childlike. We got like, it's like I put up this tweet today. If you're so concerned about my business, that means you're not working on your own business. Ironically, I got so much hate right after that. It's like, exactly.
Did you get hate after
yeah,
that?
Yeah. You know what's really funny? Angelo is 7 years old. He was bullied at ballet by an 11-year-old. It's like my son Angelo has more emotional, intellectual existence than all these people put together.
Yeah.
Like literally,
yeah, most adults.
Literally my 7-year-old is a nicer person than these people. Mm-hmm. He can hold a better conversation. He has better moral values than all these haters out there. Mm-hmm. And all these people out there that are bullies that are, like, there's this one guy that bullies me all the time and he's been arrested for domestic violence. It's like, you beat up women. It's right. like you beat women up. Mm-hmm. Like, and like, you want me to bully you about that? It's like, and you're bullying me. It's just so funny. It's like, it's just really, really ironic how people are out there always doing this. It's like, just work on your own business. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about mine. And the more people do it, they don't realize that they're keeping my name in the spotlight, and they really shouldn't. Like, the best thing you can do is, if you don't like me, is literally stop talking about me.
Right.
I'm waiting for haters to realize that the best thing they can do about anybody. So, one of my colleagues who was harshly bullied today by a dude. He bullies female trainers. His MO is to bully female trainers. That's his big gig.
Sounds like a lovely.
And when you go to his Facebook page, guess what his profile picture is? All his trophies and awards. It's yeah. Like, where's the dick pic, buddy?
Right.
Like, why don't you put a picture of your cock up there as well?
Right.
It's like, this is who I am. Like, great. You can train your dog really well to a high level of performance. but how are you helping other humans that are struggling? Mm-hmm. We're in different, we're in totally different leagues.
Yeah.
We're in totally different leagues. Mm-hmm. Like, none of these dogs could become performance dogs that we work with.
No.
Like, they're not, they're like, I would love to see that Shiba Inu. Like, I'd love to see somebody work that Shiba Inu today. I would love to see somebody work that Shiba.
Yeah. Agreed.
Who's never had a collar on, and you can't even put a slip lead on it without it screaming like it was being killed. Mm-hmm. I would love to see what somebody does with that dog.
Me too.
Oh, we'll use food drive.
He takes food, like, okay, one out of every five tries.
But it's not only that. It's like, but he has to be leashed, though, at some point. Right. He has to understand a leash.
Yep.
You have to be able to walk him on a leash. It's not a trust thing, either. Mm-hmm.
You know, and he tries to bite the leash and yes, break free.
Yes.
So it's a put, like,
and he bites his owners.
Right.
It's like
bites everything.
Yeah, bites everything. It's like, it's so incredible. And then we do a seminar series called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Jeff Gellman Seminars is a 2-day seminar series. We travel the world. We actually have 23 booked. We just booked Oahu for 2020 today. We'll be we announced 3 new locations this week. Memphis, Toronto, and Oahu.
Yep.
We're going to shoot for 30, I think, seminars. 28 or 30 Damn. Seminars in 2020.
That's like more than half the year.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. And the average, some only get maybe 20. Some get, like, this weekend, next weekend. We've got one in Seattle, and then right after that in Petaluma. It'll be like about a good 60 people at each one. It's a lot of families we can help. Mm-hmm. And then you get great, I love it how you capture great content out of it, that now then we can make little videos that help even more people. Mm-hmm. People don't understand my mission. People think it's about me. It's like, it's not about me at all. Mm-hmm. It's about helping families.
Yeah.
They don't get it. Most dog trainers are in dog training for their own egos, not to help other families.
Agreed.
They just don't get it. They just don't get it. Yeah. Yeah. And then we've got the training center here, which we are open 7 days a week. We'll be open Thanksgiving. We'll be opening for Christmas. Christmas Eve, we're open.
No shit.
Okay, we're open for Christmas Eve. And here we do daycare and we do boarding and we do our, mostly a lot of board and train. But anyway, let's start with the Q&A show. Here we go. Let's go.
Alrighty. Sorry, guys.
And first, we're going to yawn a little bit. Can you get closer to the microphone? I'll just move the microphone
closer. Just move the microphone closer.
Then it's far away from me. Next.
Francis. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Francis.
Joe gave you some hearts.
Oh, hey. Thanks, Joe.
Sonia. Hey, guys. Love you so much. Thank you for the help, Jeff. Oh. Air hugs.
Oh, you're welcome.
Looked at your place video, like you said. Now when company comes, I tell her, go home and down, and she stays like that the whole time.
And that's exactly what you're supposed to do. So here's a great example of somebody that for free was able to train their dog because they put the hard work in. And I promise to the grandmother whose 10-year-old grandson is watching the show, who owns the Great Dane puppy, I will not talk about female ejaculation on the show. So it's safe for your 10-year-old to watch the show. You know what the really part is? I put an age restriction on the show.
You did?
Yeah.
When?
I've always had age restrictions on the show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Yep.
Look at that.
Yeah. I click age restriction to follow YouTube guidelines. It's not my fault you brought your 10-year-old to the R-rated movie.
Ah, interesting.
Yeah. It's like, seriously, it's not my fault.
I didn't know you could do that on YouTube.
Oh, yeah. Well, you can make it any age.
Interesting.
Yeah. But I don't do over 18 because then Gretchen couldn't watch the show. So, you know, and we have a lot of, like, 16-year-olds. I mean, have you ever met any 4-H, mostly females, have you ever met any 4-H people?
No.
There are some 4-H, I'll say girls, which sounds stereotypical or sexist, but it's not. There's been some 4-H young women who, like, are 14, 15, 16 years old, who are great animal people, mm-hmm. like horses, pigs, cows, dogs, like incredible skill set. And they raise these animals knowing they're going to be going to slaughter.
Yeah.
Kudos to them. Kudos to them. They're really learning a lot about proper, you know, animal husbandry. Next.
Sonia said e-collar is a huge help since I'm on crutches.
Excellent. And even if you weren't on crutches, e-collar is a huge help. E-collar is not, first of all, e-collar is not a crutch. How about you like that? We have to start. By the way, I'm going nuts on Twitter now. So I've had a Twitter account for a long time. I'm finally going to be tweeting a lot. That and TikTok. So I'm having fun with that. With Twitter and TikTok, I'm having fun with that. So there you go.
Zoe schooled you today.
Don't you? I had to learn a couple of things.
Yep.
I mean, she's... Yeah, there's some...
And I've been pushing you to get on fucking Twitter.
I know, but there's some...
All it is one little line. You say these little things all day, every day.
Well, now I'm going to. Every time I have a thought or a thing, I'm just going to tweet it.
Good.
and then I can have it all permanently in there. And then you can look at it and make a meme out of it.
Yep.
So, but what's really nice, I mean, TikTok though is pretty cool, but it can be a little bit complicated because you can do some pretty cool stuff with it. And I want to be able to do cool
like
stuff with it.
A glorified version of Instagram stories. You can do like, I'll add the little things.
Yeah, but you do some pretty cool stuff.
I like
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Next.
Raquel from Brazil says, hey guys.
Hey Raquel, how are you, hon?
Yellow Belly Jacket says, I have no idea. I don't even know what that means. Levi, hey J&J, having a second dog has really forced me to step up all aspects of training.
Yes.
And my family's go-to person for dog advice. Thanks a lot for your content and other people like Sean O'Shea.
Awesome. Awesome. Hey, Sean, man. It's the only name we probably allow on the show. Next.
Jane Robinson. Update on our board, on your board and train graduate, Minnie. Remember Minnie, that little brown,
oh, yeah.
scared dog? She was in the car drooling a lot.
Yes, yes. We did a thing in the parking lot.
Yep, she said, she now goes everywhere with me in the car. No more drooling. She is still timid and scared of mechanical Santas at Home Depot.
Hey, join the club.
Gets lots of compliments. P.S. A lot of Minnie's skittishness we saw when we picked her up went away once she finished her heat cycle. There was a clear connection. Thanks for letting me know that could be some of the cause.
Yeah. Yeah, dogs, dogs.
She got her first heat here.
Oh, did she really?
She hit womanhood.
She's a woman. She's
we thought she was spayed for some reason. We're like, we don't think she's supposed to get her heat. And
right,
then we called
right,
her
right.
up, and they're like, oh, no, she's not spayed.
Right, right. No. Holy shit, there's blood in the kettle.
Holy shit. Yeah. She wasn't messy, though.
No. Well, it's like, bad. Kira's very clean.
Mm-hmm.
She's very clean.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
But yeah, it was her first
Good,
time.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Scattered Storm said, hello. Hey, Gretchen.
Hey, how are you?
Michelle, I feel I missed my calling when it comes to working with dogs. One of my three boys has autism. My caregiver responsibilities can be all-consuming. I get a lot of purpose and enjoyment working with my own dogs and overcoming challenges in my small pack. My dogs are bomb-proof with my kids. I'm very proud. Any suggestions on how I can incorporate helping others train their dogs in a way that is lower impact on my life?
Yeah. Do it. Just start talking. Share your story.
Make some videos.
Document what you do with your own dogs and post it. Don't use your first of all, your child's going to grow up, and you didn't miss your calling. How old are you? Yeah, you're not supposed to ask a woman that, but I don't give a flying fuck about rules or anything like that. I'll be 54 in a month. I'm halfway through my life. Okay? Don't use your child, no disrespect, as the excuse why you can't do what your passion is. If anything, use it as a motivator to say, I'm going to fucking do this. Whenever there's a hardship in your life, use that as a motivator. Not an excuse. Anything. Okay, kids? Anything. Use it as a motivator. All right? So, twins. Alcoholic father. They're 21 years old. Somebody interviews one of them and says, and it's like, wow, you got a really bad drinking problem. And the son says, what do you expect? Look at my dad. He's an alcoholic. How do you think I'd be turned out to be? The other son has never touched alcohol before. It's like, why haven't you touched alcohol before? You know what he says? Have you seen my father? He's an alcoholic. The last thing I want to do is be like him. All right? Got it? You can look at things a lot of different ways. You can look at things a lot of different ways. Life is short. Do what you want. Don't make excuses. All right? Now, that probably doesn't mean you can pack your bags, fly to Hawaii, leave your kids home alone, and say, fuck all you, even though people do that all the time, historically men. But what it means is, you can start doing small things that you find value. Small things. All right? Next.
The doghouse said, hey guys, beautiful Monday.
Beautiful Monday. Beautiful every day.
Beautiful
every day. I woke up this morning at, let me check my Instagram account, 308.
It was like 2:30 or some shit.
Is it 2:38 today?
Something like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. I've been getting up at like, you don't even want to know the first time I got up. I got up at 1, actually.
My alarm wasn't even set today. I went to bed at probably like 11, and I was still up at like 4.
Oh, you know what I was so proud of? I was so proud. I got to the gym at 4 a.m. this morning. I could have gone earlier, but I wanted to get some posts up, even though I put the wrong posts up. But I finally did it.
Thank God. Editor-in-chief here.
I finally did the 4 a.m. gym. I became the 4 a.m. I'm the 4 a.m. gym guy
it's
now.
It's nice, isn't it? Nobody's there yet.
Ironically, the same people that are there that are at 4 are there at 5. They're probably just...
No. You said the nose-blowing guy wasn't there.
He got there right after I said that, yeah.
And he was still there when I was working out. Yeah. Oh my God, is he there for a long time?
I don't know. Next.
We're watching you.
He's probably watching us. Next.
Probably. Levi, my nieces, who are 5 and 8, walked my 90-pound Cane Corso in a perfect heel and practiced the out command. They'll be getting a dog soon, and I want to do more drills so they have a good foundation.
Awesome. Awesome. Teach them about space. Teach the kids about pressure. Pressure literally is petting the dog. Like, approaching the dog is pressure on a dog. Hugging the dog is absolutely too much pressure. But literally approaching a dog is pressure to a dog. Next.
$4.99 top chat from Holden on Dog Training. Okay, big Rhodesian Ridgeback seems to look uncomfortable in a sit. Do you find larger dogs have a hard time in a sit position? Work through. She downs fine.
It could be a hip dysplasia issue. It could be, did the dog ever break one of its legs? It could be a genetic issue. Ask the owner. But also, we're not looking for squared sits. If a dog wants to sit like it's got a fat ass, let it sit like it's got a fat ass. I guess that doesn't make sense. If you got a fat ass, you'll probably fucking sit nice and cushiony. I guess if you got a bony ass, then you'd have to sit a little bit off to the side so it become more comfortable. So you're not sitting on your fucking coccyx bone. I don't know. I don't know enough about it. All I know is this. If a dog wants to sit a little bit to the side, it doesn't make a difference. Next.
CR. Hey, guys. So last podcast, Jeff, you talked about negative people and things in our lives.
Yeah.
I recently started dog training, but I quit my 9-to-5 today. Now what? How can I get clients?
Awesome. Oh,
well, thanks. Love ya.
You also heard me say, don't quit your 9-to-5.
Quit your day job.
Okay. You missed that part. You missed that part.
Took the leap.
Okay. I told you, don't quit your day job. I said that on a Skype that same day. I do Skypes every day. Don't quit your day job. Do your hobby. So what you can do is now get a night job that sort of like pays the bills and do it. So what are you going to do? Start giving out massive value to the community. Literally train every dog you can get your hands on. When you're first starting out and you need the cash, you want to train any dog you can get your hands on for the experience. Next. I also do business. I do business Skypes. And we can, you know, I help people build businesses. Next.
Jose. Hey, Jeff. I have a 6-month-old GSD, and every time I play fetch with my other dog, she just runs her over or nips at her legs. Any way to get rid of that habit?
Yes. Remote collar corrector for that. Yes. Absolutely. You can absolutely do that. Girl used to do that. So now I just say girl, and she stops. Next.
Kibu. Hi, Jeff. Thank you for responding to my message about the Herm Springer prong collar.
Oh, you're welcome. Yeah, get the quick release. Next.
Levi, my brother has 4 kids between 10 and 2. What are the biggest commands and behaviors should they focus on? And what is the best bite inhibition training?
Is space. Space. The kids all need to know what no means. Teach the kid place. Teach the dog out, meaning get out of here. And teach the children about space. Teach the children how to advocate for the dog. Teach the children that a dog doesn't usually historically like to be absolutely hugged. And when they're lying down, they historically want to be left alone. And a lot of times just petting can get you a bite. And feed the dog in a crate, all high value resources in the crates. But a dog can protect its dog bed. A dog can protect its owner. Make sure the owners, so that would be your uncle or your brother. That would be your brother or your sister. Make sure that they realize that the dog is the lowest form of life in the house and the kids all become, they all are more important. Next.
Scattered Storm said, ooh, we get a small rant before Jeff even finished his introduction.
Thanks, Gretch.
Lene, hey guys, happy Thanksgiving.
Hey, Lene, how are you, honey?
Happy Thanksgiving. Britt,
We'll be on Wednesday night.
Yeah.
We'll be on Thanksgiving evening. Yep.
Right?
Yeah.
Wednesday?
Yeah. Thanksgiving.
I feel like I have something going on Wednesday.
You better let me know so I can tell Cass.
Didn't we just talk about it today?
No, you said you're going to you're going to relatives' houses on Thursday.
I don't know.
Your hair done?
I don't think so. Britt, I've been feeling negative, like a bad dog owner, because dogs ran up to her walk.
Huh?
Ran up to her. Walk her just now, and she did good. And earlier, before the dogs ran at her, she walked past 2 small dogs and big, just barking like crazy.
Okay. That doesn't make you a bad dog owner. It makes your dog an asshole. So tell your dog not to do it. Correct your dog. Doesn't make you a bad dog owner.
Part of that is missing.
A lot of people have badly behaved dogs, and that's not necessarily a reflection of the owner. A lot of people have really well-behaved dogs, and that sure as hell ain't a reflection of the owner. There's a lot of dogs out there that are highly trained that are owned by assholes. So, next.
Robin, how do you stop dogs barking in kennels? They don't bark when the bark collars are on, but bark when the collars are off.
You answered your own question.
Can't keep them on 24/7, right?
No, you can't. Do you teach the dog no? What I would start doing is this. Say no, you have to be home. No, hit the top of the crate. No, have the dog come out, bonk the top of the dog. So, but no, you can't have, but your dog isn't in the crate 24/7, so the bark collar doesn't have to be on 24/7. Next.
Sonia, you must be doing something right, Jeff, because someone on Facebook hates your guts. Talk to them about an e-collar, and he went on and on about you, and I'm just like, can I get the e-collar? LOL. Keep it up.
So, not someone, many people, okay? There are many people out there. The industry pretty much has turned on me. And it's really funny. It's really funny because so many of these people, literally, I was there before they were dog trainers.
Yeah.
I was actually the one that got them into dog training. So if you don't like me now, that's fine. Mm-hmm. But it's interesting how you came to me for help. I helped you. And now you've moved on. Maybe you don't agree with how I train, or maybe you just don't like how you're not doing well and I am doing well, and you're mad at me because of that, but it's your fault because your work ethic sucks. And so now you hate me, but don't forget, like, who got you there.
Yeah.
Like, there's a dog trainer out there who literally he lives out west. He's married to somebody. This was somebody that was a fan. Came to a T3. We went to the IACP Summit convention. This goes back a couple of years ago. We gave him a ride. We didn't know. He would have never done that. He met his future wife there, and then he moved. Literally, his dog training life and his marriage are all because of us. And he literally is one of the biggest trash talkers online about me. It's like, it's so interesting how that happens. It's like, don't forget where you came from. Yeah. Don't forget where you came from. Just because you changed, that doesn't mean you should hate the people who helped you get there.
Right.
Or just because there's so many people that go to, like, say, one of these famous inspirational speakers, say, and only 1% tops will do something with that information. Mm-hmm. So the other 99% will probably think it was a waste of money. But they got the same information as the 1% that were successful. But this is also something called work ethic.
Right.
That's what people forget. Mm-hmm. People forget about work ethic. Oh my God, you get up at 3 a.m, Jeff. You need more sleep than that. I'm like, well, first of all, you don't know what time I go to bed. But second of all, it's like, but my body says I don't. Because I keep getting up at 3 a.m. without an alarm clock. I literally keep waking up at 3 and I'm up. Mm. And I'm still, and I just went to the doctor 2 days ago for my after yearly physical checkup because I missed blood work.
Yeah.
I just turned my blood work in. So that day I was like, the day we got back from Hawaii. We got back from Hawaii on a Tuesday afternoon. The next day I had that checkup. I'm like, shit, I gotta go get a blood test done. We got back too late. So that morning I got my blood work done.
Yeah.
After a cup of coffee, after a couple of cups of coffee. Later that day, he's looking at my blood work. He's like, holy shit, Jeff, like your cholesterol is low. Like the only thing I'm worried about is your sodium. I said, well, I don't eat a lot of salty foods. My fucking blood pressure was the best it's been in 10 years. Cholesterol's been great. All my blood levels, liver, everything. He goes, some of this stuff is like, Jesus Christ, you're 50, you're gonna be 54? This is not a 54-year-old's blood work. So if I was
eating healthy, working out.
So if I was that fucked up, it would show.
Right. Sodium though? That's interesting. You feel like you never put
You know what it is? Food. After I had to be hospitalized for my heart, they put me on blood pressure meds. It could be that. But I don't have a lot of sodium in my diet. I'm always looking at labels for sodium.
Me too.
Always.
I don't even own salt.
Yeah.
I don't have a salt shaker.
Yeah. My mom always taught me, like, Jeff, 450 or below.
Yeah.
450. Like, if you look at, like, like I had to buy some sauce for, I went to the Asian market to pick up raw food for the dogs. Mm-hmm. And, I bought turkey necks, but I couldn't buy them in bulk because the bulk guy was closed. The guy was closed. The meat market was closed. So I just buy them out of the freezer. But anyway, I want to get sauce for the shumai. Mm-hmm. And so they're like, if you haven't been to this one, what's the name of that Asian market, by the way?
Good Fortune
in Providence. It's a wonderful place.
They but have everything.
Everything. But they have literally a whole three rows of just sauce.
Probably all super salty.
And I'm looking at the back of them, and I'm looking at the back of them, and I'm trying to be like, give me something like below, you know, 800 at least.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next. No good. I found one.
Thomas. Well said. It's about helping families, helping dogs.
Yeah. That's what this business is about. I'm a pet dog trainer. Next.
Jack says, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Hey, Jack.
Yep. Next.
Thomas Sandberg. Saving dogs in many cases.
Nice.
T. Glenn. Hey guys, thanks for all the Q&As. Can you refer me to a video you've probably made already in regards to a dog jumping up on people without being invited?
Yeah, well, the dog shouldn't jump up on people at all.
Well, if there's a command.
There's a command for jump, yeah, but that's like, if it's a stranger, I wouldn't let my dog do that. I've got a video under my YouTube channel, how to stop jumping. Guys, there's a Thomas Sandberg that just clicked on our page right now. Thomas Sandberg, C-S-A-N. It says, use pink salt, super healthy. Click on him.
Himalayan pink salt.
Okay, yep. We use Himalayan pink salt. If you want to know about raw feeding for dogs, that's the guy to talk to. All right? That's the contact for raw feeding for dogs right there. All right? Next.
Boom. Cassandra, hey guys, just checking in to see you. Wait, did you finish that?
Oh, I've got a video.
I have a video.
How to stop jumping. Yeah, it's easy to do. It's easier to teach than to sit. Next.
Cassandra, hey guys, just checking in to see where the sign up for the reactive dog class will be posted. Thanks.
It'll be underneath. We'll probably highlight it in our newsletter. I'll do a post on Facebook, a post on Instagram, post on TikTok, post on Instagram, our website, and then underneath services, it'll be underneath services, and you'll be able to get it right there. It's limited to 10 spots. It's a real reactive dog class, a real one. Mm-hmm. Like we won't tell you to like. Go stand outside or your dog's too reactive. Within the first 15 minutes, all the dogs will be stopped being reactive. Next.
Kibu. Sorry, Herm Springer prong collar with the clip closure. Have you had any experience with these collars with clasp closers? I have CP and arthritis. A regular prong collar can't open and close.
There's a couple of things you can do. You can get the quick release. It's possible for user error or in manufacturing defects. But the way that the quick release works, I don't know if anybody even knows this. That quick release that they use, does anybody know the history of that? I mean, we can probably go farther back. That's actually from the garment industry. The part that goes like that is from the garment industry. They had rubber tabs on the end. What they did was it was used to stretch fabric. And what happens is the harder you pull on it, the tighter it gets. But that's from the garment industry. They used it to stretch fabric. Yeah. Hmm. Yep. Next.
Interesting. Ari. Hi, guys. Want to teach my dogs to not approach dogs when off leash with A command to leave them alone, and B, a command to allow them to greet a known dog.
So you know what? That can be confusing for your dog. Start off with this. Don't ever meet a dog. Just start out with that. Because most dogs you don't want to meet. So always teach your dog what no means. Make sure you've got a good recall. And we won't power train your dog. Next.
Elizabeth tried to intro treadmill today and did not go well. Followed protocol, but once I turned it on, he freaked and would not budge.
Yep.
Tried to work through it. No luck. Tried later. No luck.
Yep. Try tomorrow. Okay. Try tomorrow. All right. Get up to 1 mile per hour and use a prong collar. Do small pops. If the dog puts on the brakes, you don't want to wear down their pads. Don't worry about it. Also, put the dog on it with it off, off of it. On it with it off, off of it. On it with it off, off of it. Don't give up. Next.
Levi, Django, 18 months, had lunged at our neighbor's 10-year-old pit. I apologized and asked him if we could spend a half hour working through it. Set it up. He loaded and I shocked at 100 and repeated. Every time he tried and then went into avoidance and practiced place while the pug walked around. Anything else to do for this?
He's in avoidance now. Now you work on existence. So now what you can do is click or train your dog. Every time the pug walks by and the dog moves its head, click and reward. Unless it gets the dog so elevated. Okay? So nobody knows how much positive dog training we do. Nobody understands that. How much clicking and treating goes on. We don't use treats. We use the dog's daily food. We do have dried up hot dog, which we actually make ourselves. Not the hot dog, but the drying up part. And then we also use dried up beef liver.
The drying up part.
Right. We dry it up. Ooh, big deal. We turn the oven on 125, you know. I mean, we do have to lay out, you know, wax paper.
We cut them into these little pieces, like, yeah. Well,
that's what interns are for. So
literally.
The interns better be doing that.
I'm pretty sure.
If not, you know, we can get a machine that does that, by the way. You can just get a blender that just chops.
Oof, turn it into freaking hot dog stew. Ew.
So, next.
Did you answer it?
Yeah, I said yeah. So, and then start rewarding good choices.
Okay.
Next.
Brit, maybe when the dog charged her, it did something, but when walking past dogs on a leash and the gate, she's still good. Healing, downing is great.
Okay.
Levi, I already read that.
Okay.
Gretchen. Wow, you keep the age restrictions below 18 for me?
Yeah, literally for you. Just for you, Gretch.
Just for you.
Seriously, I thought of you. I was going to be like, because, well, YouTube just changed their law. YouTube just changed one of their policies about children. So I thought about, oh my gosh, I can't make it below 18. Gretchen's not 18 yet. Next. And she's not the type that would lie.
She wasn't done yet.
Oh.
She said, I do 4-H too. I'm showing someone else's steer next year. 1,000 pounds. First time. Can't wait to wrestle him.
Awesome. Proud of you, Gretch.
Nicole, should I wait until my puppy is fully trained to begin integrating fully to the household? Example, not being in the crate, X-Pen most of the day. He's 6 months old and absolutely can't be trusted. Is this normal?
So, God, yeah. Just to let you guys know, I crate my dogs. So right now, Girl is 8, Kira is 5, Tex is 3. So the last two dogs that I had that died were 11 and 10. And they lived in crates at night and when I couldn't keep my eyes on them. Unless they were outside. Crate your dog. It'll save its life. Next.
Nicole, should I wait until... I already read that. Sorry. Amanda, hi, silly question. What is the difference between place and stay, and when do you use each one? Thanks for all you do.
There's a humongous difference. We don't use stay at all. Stay is always implied. So sit means sit stay. Down means down stay. Place means place stay. Place is on an object. The way we train it is you go to that object, historically a dog bed, a platform, could be a blanket, could be a bath mat, could be, a park bench, but place is go to that object, lie down, put your head down and relax. Stay, historically stay means like stay, but we don't use the word stay. We have something called an implied stay. You do the command until you're told either break or to do another command. Next.
Canadian girl. Hey, what would I train to get a 5-month and a 1.5-year-old dog to listen to me when they are together playing? They're kept separate and trained separate, etc., but I might as well be on Mars.
So remote collar train, those are extremely high level distractions. They go deaf. So remote collar train them so you can override their arousal. Next.
Oh shit! I just hit somebody's comment by accident. Okay, there we go. Mouse police. Hi. Do you think it is safe to bonk a resource guarding dog, 6-month-old Australian cattle dog that will bite if I get too close to the food and crate?
I would use a remote collar. Put the dog on a back tie, but yes, bonking is extremely safe, but you also have to know how to do it. There's a skill set. I would use a remote collar though. So a 6-month-old resource guarding dog, I would stop that tonight. Literally stop it now. Yes, it's at a high level. It's a high punisher. Just think about this concept. You're 6 months old. You're guarding food from me. I'm busting my fucking ass every day to pay for your food, and you're going to guard it from me? Nope. At 6 months old, that stops tonight. High-level consequence. Next.
Nicole, I took the plunge and got the mini educator since a couple Q&As ago. Began conditioning with recall in place. She's doing great. However, I'm afraid she may only respond with it on. How do I avoid this?
E-collar? Mm-hmm. Have they started using it yet? Okay.
Started conditioning it for recall in place.
Okay.
She's doing great.
So you're doing great. Okay. 1,000 times. Get up to punishment level. We have something called CS, continuous stim, NCS, non-compliant stim, and then there's correction mode. And then you've got to proof it around as many high level distractions as you can. So can you take your dog and call it off of a deer? That's the thing. So, but you're just starting and you want to know when you can stop. Fully train your dog first. But when your dog's off leash outside, have a remote collar on it. When you're driving, keep your seatbelt on. As long as you're alive, have a will and life insurance. Next.
Maria, hi again from Poland. Love you guys.
Hey, Poland, how are you?
Mario, hello guys, listening while at the vet. My dog started limping after playing in the backyard a couple of days ago. The worst behaved dog here is being pet while she whines and whines. Go figure.
Hopefully it's not. I'm sure it's going to be fine. I'm not going to put negative energy out. Next.
Levi, have you ever thought about using a hydrotherapy tank, underwater treadmill at the center, or for your own dogs? Or do you find swimming just as effective and less hassle?
No, I would love to be able to have the budget for that, but probably, actually, I do have the budget for it. I can go buy one tomorrow. It's about priorities, though. I think my next big investment for the center is probably going to be either a slat mill or a carpet mill. Also, probably adding more stuff to the puppy confidence building room. Right now, I put most of my money into payroll. That's where I put my money into. I've got about a 35% payroll expense because I, you know, that's where it is. If there's any extra money, I'll hire somebody else to, so we can keep. But right now, we're looking for a social media intern. That probably will turn into paid work. One of our part-time social media people will become probably a paid full-time person, all for making free content. We don't charge for any of our social media. Next.
Maria, I know that many people would be happy having the dog not pulling on their side, but I am not. I tried 180, e-collar, and leash guidance. All of it didn't work. My dog is nervous and fearful being on the leash, but it's okay off. I have no contact with the dog on the walks. Everything makes him not listening to me and rush in front of my leg.
Goes in front of your leg. Mm-hmm. You need to do a spatial pressure exercise. We've got there's a video of me doing that. There's the videos of Joelle doing it. We'll make an official video. Mm-hmm. We'll make an official spatial pressure exercise. Next.
Gina, 9-month-old Howl mix, showed signs of anxiety when hubby got deployed. Started researching it and found y'all. Leash reactive, overall anxiety. Worked our butts off the past month and he's doing much better.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Kenzie, good evening. I'm having trouble with my dog coming out of the crate super excitedly. I've tried the bonker and it worked for a few seconds, but when I say let's go, he's back to being crazy. Any tips?
Yeah, put him on a leash, prong collar, have him come out of the crate, and pop him up into a sit.
Brandon, 1-year-old staff-eyed cheered bully, continues to lunge at my son. Seems like he tries to bite him. What should I do?
Okay, there's way too many variables. There's way too many variables for me to There's way too many variables for me to know what's going on there. It's a dangerous situation, a potentially dangerous situation. I'd be uncomfortable answering that question without knowing right now. You can stop. Keep them apart. How old is the son?
It doesn't say.
I'm uncomfortable giving that information, not because I'm going to give you the wrong information or don't know what I'm doing. We fix that all the time. But if I give you the wrong information or you took it wrong because there is an art to it, I would hate to see a child hurt. Next.
Maria, my dog constantly breaks place command. We are after all the place training, CS and NCS. I was correcting it on the 8 levels higher than working level hundreds of times during the day. Today I got so annoyed by this that I gave a high level stim. It got audible, but it didn't break till the end of the day. I feel like my dog is making fun of me trying all those things. Did I do good?
What are they trying to stop?
Kept breaking place, like, because she's correcting it at 8 levels higher.
Eight levels high is not. That's not a
correct. And then she went to a high level stim and he didn't break again.
Yeah, no shit.
So she said, did I do the right thing?
You tell me. You answered your own question. So you did something that actually worked. So instead of tickling the fucking dog's balls, you fucking came down like a goddamn fucking brick and said, stop fucking getting off place. Your dog was playing you. And now you fucking read your dog the riot act and said, tough shit, keep your ass on place. And your dog's like, why? You said, I thought tickling my balls was the game. Sorry, now I know the game. Don't move. Next.
Kenzie, the rest of the day is mentally stimulating and I run him 3 to 4 times per day for about 10 to 15
minutes. Good. Yeah, you don't need to tire your dog out to keep your dog in a 5-hour, 6-hour, 7-hour place. Next.
Spuds K, your favorite hater, berated these disabled girls on an e-collar group for asking him not to be, albeit, and stop using disability-related slurs. One of them at least was banned from the page. Deplorable.
Okay, I don't understand what that.
I don't know either.
Yeah, I don't know.
Somebody berated somebody on Facebook. What else is new?
Yeah, what else is new? Yeah, social media is just full of toxic people historically. There's very, very few people that actually are helpful on social media.
Yeah.
Very few people. It's really too bad because social media literally can change the world. But also, this is what the thing about social media actually is. Let me rephrase that. Social media is fantastic. It reveals people. If you're a jerk on social media, you're probably a jerk. If you're nice on social media, you're probably nice. I mean, there's people that will play the game. They'll be nice, but then they'll be really assholes. I know a bunch of those. But historically, though, eventually, if you go to someone's social media page, go to their personal page, go to their business page, read through all their comments, read the way they respond to other people, too. You're going to get a good idea of who these people are. Next.
Shadow. Hi, Jeff. What are your tips regarding dealing with other people's misbehaving dogs barking and lunging, pulling towards you? I have a service dog, and fakes, poorly trained ESAs are becoming a problem.
Well, if they come into my bubble, you have to decide where your bubble is. I mean, your bubble can't be 20 feet. That's not impractical. I got a 5-mile bubble. I don't want anybody dogs within 5 miles of me.
Right.
So
if
I feel that my dog or myself is in danger, I'll kick the dog. I don't care what it is. Next.
I got lunged at today.
Did you where?
In Home Depot with my two dogs with me. And like as soon as I walked in, there was like this big yellow lab and it like end of the leash, like lunged. I'm like grabbed my dogs and like pulled them closer to me because it literally almost made contact with Wes.
Did you say anything?
He didn't give a shit. No. I just kept walking.
Really? You?
And even one of the employees was like, if your dog keeps acting like that, you won't be able to come in here. I was just like,
wow. It was your day off too.
My business.
Yeah.
I was going to say shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Next.
I'm not a dog trainer off the clock. Tommy. Yeah. Hi, JJ.
Hey, how are you, Tommy?
$4.99 from the Noble Dogs. That's weird. That didn't show up at the top. Did you get it?
I don't get them. Oh, yeah. There's something flashing. I don't pay attention to my screen, though. You're supposed to get them.
Okay. So
yeah.
$4.99.
Sorry, Grant. We're just getting it now.
It didn't pop up.
Yeah.
Have you tried BAT and CAT? Why are some trainers so adamant that it's the best way to resolve aggression and some could care less about it?
Probably because it works for them. So what we do is probably similar to BAT. We just don't have acronyms. So historically, BAT takes a really long time. But the best way to do all this stuff is try it yourself. Have you seen the book on BAT, the protocols that you have to do for BAT? So what we do, I mean, remote collar can eliminate BAT. But we stop the unwanted behavior, and then we reward the wanted behavior. We use distance. We this concept of keeping dogs always under threshold, we don't do that. If anything, we push dogs past threshold because there's something out there called life. Right? There's something out there called life. We want dogs to know how to behave in a crazy world, and especially in an unpredictable world. So, but what I tell people is we've had many clients that have been tried BAT, and then in one session with us, they made more progress. And they've been on doing BAT for 12 months. But it's possible they did BAT wrong. But I've seen the book. The protocol is pretty extreme. But that might have just been from one trainer. So I can't give you an expert opinion because I have never tried it. But I've heard enough about it that I know that what we do is along the similar concept, but just more quicker and effective. Next.
Levi, there are times when I call the dog's name and they seem to understand which command I want before I say it. Should I still say the command and mark with yes?
Yes. Well, it depends if you're training or not. I mean, if it's a trained dog, who cares? Next.
Gibby, hi guys. My dog is growling when I put his collar or prong on. He has attacked me before with his resource problems. It's getting scary, Jeff.
So muzzle up the dog and correct him for doing that. Next.
Levi, for training two dogs when they're together, do I forget about trying to get name recognition with commands?
It all depends. So I run right now I have three main dogs. So most people see me with Kira, Tex, and Girl. I don't give a, it's just like here, they all come. Plots, they all lie down. Go in your kennel, they all go in their kennel. Get in the truck, they all go in the truck. I don't do name recognition training with my dogs. For you, if it's important to you, do it. Next.
Maria, I was really scared to mess up my dog by hitting him high stim. I tried it being pushed to the wall by its doorbell behavior. recommend it to everybody. It works like magic.
Yeah, so nobody wants to hurt their dog, including me. Everybody, for some reason, thinks that I correct dogs and get pleasure out of it.
Right?
It's like, so fucking it's weird. Like, I'm trying to stop it. I'm trying to actually make the dog safe for the owner and for ourselves. Like, I don't think people realize the dogs that we work with. Like, and we're not sport dog trainers that want dogs to bite. You know? I mean, with Kira, who does bite work, I want her to bite. But the dogs that come in here, we don't want them biting. So when they try to bite us, it has to be stopped. I've got staff here. I can't have dogs biting staff. The dog has to know that biting is not acceptable. There's 10 people here, and my son is here. The dog has to know right away it's not allowed to bite anymore. And it does. It learns. Nobody's getting bit here. Next. Mm-hmm.
Shadow, e-collars have been a great way to teach my dog to ignore other dogs and for off-lead training. He's been doing great.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Andrea, hey, J&J, just got a prong collar for my 5-month-old Great Dane Mastiff, Odin.
No, it took you so long. Holy shit.
I've worked him in the house with it. What's my next step?
Driveway. Go up and down the driveway. I just did a short Instagram video on that. Did I put it up yet? I put it up. About your driveway. Work him up and down the driveway.
Yeah, that's been up for a while.
Oh, has
you
it?
You ask that like every show.
Oh.
It's been up for like a month.
Oh,
sorry. You scroll the feed, guys.
Scroll the feed. If you like the show, guys, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like the show, give me a thumbs down. If you're not part of our family, hit the Sally Canine Training, and then hit the bell. Hit the bell twice to get all the notifications. Next.
Levi, I get up for dog walking and then the gym before work every day at 4.
Awesome.
Other people just don't have the work ethic or discipline.
Yep. That's what discipline is big. Mm-hmm. Discipline is huge.
It really is.
Yep. Like when we travel, like
people
next.
People think that like we just wake up and like, can't wait to go to the gym. It's like there's definitely days where I'm like, I'd rather lay my ass in bed.
Yeah.
It's like, no, I need to go to the gym.
It's called discipline.
Discipline.
It's called discipline.
You go on the days that you don't want to go.
And you want another thing about habits are people about structure. Like, can you like what structure mean in your dog? It's like, well, what structure mean in your life?
Right.
I wake up.
Same routine.
I wake up every morning, lately between 2 and 3, but usually around 3 o'clock. I go downstairs. I make a big cup of iced coffee. I come upstairs.
How many pods in that thing?
2. I come up. It's a big glass. I come upstairs. I sit down. I get in bed, get back in bed, and I start responding to comments from overnight. I'm sending out a lot of hearts, a lot of thank yous, answering some questions. I have a podcast going on in the background, so I'm putting good stuff in my brain. I don't watch the news. I don't read the newspaper. Then I create lately 3 pieces of content before I go to the gym. And now that I'm on Twitter and TikTok, I'll be doing at least 5 or 6 pieces of content all before I go to the gym. Go to the gym, back home by 6:30. And then usually I'm out the door by 7 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Yep. Angela's with me. We come here. We run the dogs. Come to work. It's called fucking discipline.
Right.
It's discipline. When we're on the road, we work out.
Yep.
When we're on the road, we eat healthy. We stay in Airbnb so we can cook.
Yeah.
It's called discipline. All it is discipline, guys. It's all about discipline. But work ethic is huge too. Everybody wants everything fast. Everybody.
Mm-hmm.
It's so funny that, like, I had Zoe clean out the file cabinet there. Like, we're going through a whole, like, we're filling up dumpsters with old stuff, you know? And she found an invoice from 1990. I showed it to you. She found an invoice from Miko Exoticware, which is my old company. Miko Exoticware. It's someone's invoice, packing slip, shipping label in a manila folder. From 1993. I mean, that's not that old. It's not like 1893. From 1993. 16 years ago.
No, that would be... Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry. 2000. I'm sorry. Did I say 1993? I'm sorry. 2003.
I mean, okay. I was right with math for once. Yeah. I'm like, wait.
That's 26
years. I'm like second guessing myself because you're always right with math.
That's 26 years ago. It's from, I was thinking 1990. No, it's from 2003.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was great. Yeah. It was wonderful. It brought back a lot of memories. I'm going through all the merchandise and I'm like, oh, yeah, I remember all that stuff. Yep. I remember all that stuff.
Levi also said, do you or Joelle ever use the sauna as part of athletic training? If I had one, I would. When we go on the road and go to, like, L.A., I'll totally go in the sauna, but I don't. regularly now.
You know what? No, but you know what's really fun? I think in
my showers are hot enough to be sauna.
I think in you know, you can turn it. They make showers now that you actually can make into a sauna as well.
Ooh.
Yeah, yeah. Because what it is it's just air. The shower is just airtight.
Got it.
So it's airtight, and then but there's also a button for steam. Is it in Denmark or the Netherlands that all new construction they have to have those little? Each house has to have a little sauna in it.
Really?
Yeah. Yep. Yep. It's either Denmark, Norway, or the Netherlands. I think.
I love saunas.
But we're talking about those small little like two. It's a two little one or two person one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's part of.
I like the dry ones. I don't like the steam.
These are the dry ones. Yeah. These are the dry ones I'm talking about. Yeah.
Nice.
Yep. Next.
Gibby, I don't want to see a behaviorist in Scotland who will just throw food at him. And if I do get an e-collar, I will get fined because they're illegal.
Okay, so from my understanding, who's that?
Gibby.
E-collars are not illegal in Scotland. They are highly frowned upon, but they have not passed a law yet. I'm pretty sure. In fact, I'm almost 100% positive. In fact, I am 100% positive. Wales, yes. Scotland, no. They did not vote on that yet. Next.
Tom said, use pink salt. Super healthy.
Thank you, Tom. That's Thomas. Tom, I want you to be clicking on Thomas's. Yep, next.
Mouse, please. Hi, Jeff. I think it's safe. Think it's safe to bonk a resource guarding dog that will bite if we get too close.
He already mentioned that.
We already read
yep.
that one.
Yep.
So it must have been a double. One big weirdo. Why are you against dog parks?
I usually say, hey, everybody can answer that question, but it'll fill up the feed and we're already back. We're back so far already. Because dog parks are filled up with a lot of unknown dogs. You don't know anything about their health. You don't know anything about their behavior. It's with owners that, are in denial. Dogs get overly aroused. Dogs get attacked. Dogs get into fights. Dogs die. You can pick up giardia. You can pick up a lot of different illnesses there. What I do is I off-leash train my dogs and I make my own dog parks, which is anywhere I want. Next.
Thomas Sandberg said, thanks for the kind words.
Oh, you're welcome, Thomas.
Maria, on my dog's neck appeared to be a mechanical injury or tumor. So my vet told me it's because of prong and forbid using it. Do you think it's possible? I need prong to walk this powerful dog.
I would get another opinion. What's your vet's opinion on the prong in general? So it's really funny. Do you remember Ronan? Ronan died a little bit ago. At one point, every once in a while, I don't know if you ever saw this while you were here, he'd get like this little mass underneath his neck.
I think I did, yeah.
Okay. It was funny because I remember once I had a vet who was not my normal vet, but she worked in the office and nobody liked going to her, including myself, because mm-hmm. of her personality. And she really, like, and this prongs that, like, she was really mean towards me. And I'm like, and then I found Ronan's old records. Ronan was pulled from Turkey, which you can't do. You can look up the Kengel Lady of Germany. Look her up. The Kengel Lady of Germany. She pulls Turkish Kengels, not Anatolian Shepherds, but Turkish Kengels out of Germany. And guess what? From a very young age, during his first series of vet checkups in Germany, and all his papers are in German too. Mm-hmm. It talks about this swollen neck thing. Like, he's had that problem since he was born. Mm-hmm. So it's got nothing to do with the prong collar. So what I would do is I'd find out your vet's opinion on the tool itself. If they're against prong collars, I'd get another opinion. Next.
Cassandra, when is the sign up for the reactive dog class going to go live? I have an interview this week and will be away from my phone all of Tuesday, but I want to make sure I get a spot.
Don't worry. It will not go up. Tomorrow's Tuesday. It probably will go up by Wednesday.
Yeah,
but you make sure that happens, actually.
I already emailed Amanda.
Okay, thanks.
Kevin, hi, guys. Jeff, how do you get a dog to walk on a leash that only wants to sit and lay down? I try with prong collar high up on the neck, but dog refuses to take steps.
So do north, south, east, west. North, south, east, west. So let's pretend you're heading north. That didn't work. There's a couple things. That didn't work. Pop, pop, pop. Up, dog's not moving. First of all, are you popping hard? Usually, because the dog can walk. Take the leash off. The dog said, don't do this, please. But if you took that leash off and walked away from that dog, I bet you the dog would fucking run around the neighborhood. So we know the dog can walk. Unless it's like a bulldog and it's 110 degrees outside and you've overwalked your dog. you know, or accidentally, like, all four legs just fell off the dog, you know, and then we'll throw it in water and name it Bob. So what you can do is you go north, then you go south, try the same thing south. That doesn't work. Go east, same thing east. That doesn't work. Go west, same thing doesn't work. One of those ways should get the dog moving. If that doesn't work, walk right into the dog. Literally, walk into the dog with your feet, shuffling your feet, popping the leash away from you, using spatial pressure. See if that gets the dog to move. Also, remote collar, a little bit of motivation right there. So a lot of people say, oh no, use food. How about if the dog doesn't take food? See, this is the problem with food. We train with food. Every dog that's out there has been trained with food, but we have dogs that don't take food. So if food is your only answer and you work with a dog that doesn't take food, now what are you gonna do? Everybody needs to know how to use compulsion, which is all leash work. Technically, force. Next.
Maria, my dog is so nervous when we are going to new places that it's hard for me to handle. Is it how it has to be? Can I do something with it?
God, yeah. So don't use nervousness as an excuse. So if your dog's out of control, that's not necessarily nervousness. Your dog's just out of control. Teach your dog obedience how to heal next to you, whether it's nervous or not. Next.
Levi, when coming to a street crossing, do you always stop even if it's safe and there's a stop command? Or if in heel, should they just stop?
If I've got the light, I keep going. And if there's no light at all and I look both ways but I'm walking, I keep going. Next.
Elizabeth, treadmill. How long do I let him struggle before taking him off and trying again? I can't even get him to walk down the stairs to the basement anymore. He's so scared of it. I'm kind of afraid he's going to bite me if I keep pushing him.
So put a muzzle on the dog. For steps, that's easy. Start at the top of the steps, grab the leash and say, let's go, and go one step at a time. Then speed up a little bit. Next.
Cheyenne, hey guys, been a while since I checked in. Oreo is still potty training and she learned how to open her crate. So I have another lock on it now. Her anxiety is going down. She's on place now.
Good. Awesome job. Yeah. Zip ties are fantastic for crates. Next.
Kevin, Jeff, why do all local humane societies use positive-only training? It's dumb and dangerous. These dogs only have so much time left.
Not local ones, national ones, everyone, because they don't care about the dogs. They only care about their fundraising. Sorry if that offends anybody. And if you're a humane society that disagrees with that, why aren't you training your dogs? Why are you banning tools? Why do your contracts say that all dogs have to be trained in a positive manner? Why do your contracts say you can't use this tool, this tool, this tool, this tool? Why do your contracts say you can't crate your dog? Did you know that? There are people that their contracts, in their adoption contracts, say you're not allowed to crate your dog. If you truly care about families and dogs, why do you put such limitations on dogs? Why do you do that? You know why you do that? Because you only care about fundraising and you're thinking with your heart, not your head, and you truly don't care about the dog. You truly don't care about the dog. Because if you cared about the dog, you'd want that dog out of your shelter permanently, not returned. But that makes for good social media, having an overstocked kennel to get a lot of fundraising. Next.
Kevin, Jeff, Ontario is going to lift our pit bull ban soon. Yeah.
Good.
That's good.
Yeah, all that stuff's being overturned. The people need to start speaking up. And the five people that are yelling and screaming against all this stuff, they need to be squashed. Next. The people need to start speaking up for the freedom of use of tools. In Vancouver, Canada, they tried to pass legislation that says you cannot say no to your dog harshly. It was in the legislation. You cannot say no. It was overturned, but it was up for vote. You pay a politician, you know, $500,000, they'll fucking vote on anything. We're banning ketchup. No more ketchup.
That's sad.
You know what I mean? I mean, they don't give a shit. Not all politicians. That's not a wide paintbrush stroke. But everybody celebrated down in Hillsborough and down in Florida, I mean, for greyhound racing. Oh, thank God they banned greyhound racing. Guess what's next, boys and girls? Agility, fly ball, trick training, service dogs, bite work, dancing with dogs, choreographed swimming, all the dock diving, all that's next. Watch. Within 10 years, you won't be able to do much with your dog except for take a bunch of fucking newspapers, put it on the ground, blow it, fucking set up a fan, put the dog on the goddamn newspapers, and use it as a fucking paperweight. That's what you're going to be left with your dog. You won't be able to do shit with your dog anymore because people are banning anything the dog doesn't want to do voluntarily. It's horrific what's going on out there. People need to stand up and speak up. Everybody thinks I'm crazy. Just listen. Just watch. Just watch. It's all happening. It's all happening. And everybody's afraid. Everybody's afraid to say anything because people give a shit too much what people care or think about them. Speaking the truth is hard. It takes courage. It takes bravery. Nobody wants to do that. Nobody. Next.
Atmospheric. How would you introduce young puppies to leash training?
Slowly. Next.
Christine, the final exam from an online dog training academy that at least covered punishment techniques was literally mostly about how important it is to not correct or punish a dog. It wasn't even subtle.
I know. And I know the online academy. It's a waste of money. Next.
Brandon, like losing my voice. My son is 9 and was timid in the beginning, but has developed a liking to the dog. My youngest son is the only one he lunges at. I haven't done any obedience training classes. Not sure if it'll even help. At some point in time, I want to keep the dog, but it's either training classes, balls getting caught, or putting him up for adoption. My girlfriend makes the rules.
Okay, well, that's a dysfunctional relationship, number one. Number two, all dogs need to be trained. You don't need to use a training class. Watch our free videos. Next. You can't expect your dog just to just train. Hold on, I want to make a comment. So, Gibby, you said there's a ban on e-collars in Scotland. Are you 100% sure on that? Because I have somebody that's working directly with your legislators there, and they said there's not. I just talked to her last week. Literally, I just talked to her last week. She said there's no ban. She literally is working with your Scottish Parliament. She literally has the Minister of Farming there, or whoever, agriculture, or whoever does that Department of Laws on animals. And there was no ban on it. So that's news to me. Unless it just happened, but I would have probably gotten an email saying it happened. And I have got colleagues who are active on social media right now. I've got 5 trainers that I know personally that are using shock collars, and it's all over their social media pages. They advertise their classes. They do huge, huge business, and they're all using remote collars. And they talk about them every day. Wales, it's illegal. England and Scotland, my understanding is. I'm not living over there. But you've got to really make sure, is it illegal or is it highly frowned upon? Is it actually against the law? Next.
You sure?
Yeah, I want to know. I mean, that's...
I know. You've nexted me like 20 times tonight.
Oh, am I sure about next? Am I sure about the law?
About next.
Next, yeah, I'm sure. Next.
Okay, cool. Gibby said he doesn't guard his food bowl. It's stupid shit, like tissues and stuff that he finds outside.
Guarding is guarding. So bonk him. No bonk. But get a remote collar. If it is illegal, buy one on the black market and put a bandana on it. But it's illegal, but it's... So say it was illegal. It's not illegal inside your house. Next.
Brandon. I already read that. Andrea. With the prong collar on my pup. How do I size it to him, and do I keep his flat collar on with the prong collar?
Yeah, flat collar could be for the dog tags and the rabies tags. That goes below. Prong collar, I've got a video on how to size a prong collar. Next.
Gretchen, your comments on the internet reflecting people's true self is so true. I made some IG stories on that. People who say, go educate this account, are just looking to start a fight to make themselves look smart. So unnecessary and not good for your heart.
Yep, it is. A lot of hate. You know what? You know what it is? I've got empathy for the haters. Believe it or not, I do. I've got empathy. I've got massive amounts of empathy. I'm so sorry that you're struggling in life, that you feel that you have to do this to make yourself feel good. I've got empathy for you. I care about you as a human being. And what got you there? And I want people to know that it's a crappy way to live. And a lot of people, it's their Trojan horse for supposedly caring about dogs, but they hate other things too. It's not a dog thing. It's an excuse to hate. It's just an excuse to hate. Next.
Carolina, any chance you'll have a seminar in Arizona next year? I'm in Mexico, but would gladly drive for that.
I'm trying for the Phoenix, Tucson area. So I'm looking for locations in, San Diego or Ramona, we're probably going to be announcing very, very soon. So that'll cover our Southern California one. But I'm looking for, and we're in Las Vegas too. So you can go to Las Vegas. For Mexico, Ramona might work. But for, we're trying for, if anyone knows of a location in, we're looking for Phoenix or Tucson and also Denver area. Next.
Shadow, thanks, Jeff. I appreciate it. 5 feet is my general rule, but with physical limitations, it may be difficult to kick. LOL.
Yeah.
I may start carrying my cane with my service dog so I can smack.
There you go.
Or pepper spray.
Yep. Use your cane. Whack him on the head. Next.
Lay says, hi, guys.
Hey, Lay. How are you? Love you.
Levi, in the dog's crates, do they have beds? I was away for work for a month, and my wife was with the dogs. Came home to both ripped up beds.
So if they rip them up, no, because they could die. Next.
Lay, Tank, and I have been around my mother's two small dogs with no issues. However, her Weimaraner is very scared and keeps snapping at muzzle Tank. Any suggestions?
One more time.
Tank and I have been around my mother's two small dogs with no issues.
Okay.
However, her Weimaraner is very scared and keeps snapping at muzzled Tank. Any suggestions?
Yeah, you tell your mother to put the Weimaraner in a crate. Next.
Levi, I think it's due to lack of stimulation because I do most of the walking and they get 2 to 3 hours when I'm home.
The crate thing? No. You can exercise the fuck out of your dog. You can still destroy it. The bed. So here's something really funny. Mac, he lives outside. He's got a doghouse. There's heat. Don't worry. He's well cared for. I gave him a deer head the other day. Please. He's well cared for. He's all set for the fucking year. He ate the head of a deer. Like literally, I can walk outside every morning and I can say, Mac, you're a piece of shit. And he'd be like, that's okay. I got a deer head this year. So he loved it. Yeah.
That's good.
He's had the same bed for 3 years. The same bed for 3 years. So in his doghouse is a place cot, which raises him up off the ground, and a one of those posturpedic beds. It's about like that thick. He's had that bed for 3 years. I'm like, you know what? Let me buy a new bed for you. Let me buy a new bed for you. And then I'm saying, you know what? What if you rip it up? So let me take the new bed, put it down. Let me take your old bed, put it on top of the new bed, just for that extra cushion. And then we went away. I got a phone call within 24. I got a text. Linda texts me when I go away. We rarely talk. This time zone or whatever. So Mac destroyed the bed. I said, the old one too? She's like, oh no. The old one's fine.
That's so weird, huh?
Just the new one.
None of this clean new bedding in here.
Right. So it's like it's like I made a bed sandwich. The cot, the old bed, and the new bed. So literally, he took the fucking bread off and he fucking ate up the ham and cheese.
Why is that? Why did he eat the new bed?
And he left the bread alone.
The old dirty one.
Yeah.
Like, I love this bed.
He literally left the ones that he's been sleeping on for 3 years.
Hey, if it ain't broke.
That hasn't been washed, by the way.
He's like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah, so guess what? So guess what he gets? He gets no new bed. Nope. So it's the way it is. Next.
Britt, every walk now, I down my German Shepherd with no command. It feels great.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Gina, lady passed us and her dog rushed us. Max backed away and growled. She yelled at me for using a prong. Told her, my dog isn't the one rushing other dogs. Anything right. I can do for Max when this happens?
Probably just learn to say go fuck yourself to people. You know what I mean? It's like...
People are crazy.
People are just so like, there's something called logic that they don't have a grasp of in reality. Your dog lunged at my dog lunged, and I'm the problem? Okay.
I don't think Max even
just growled.
Backed away and growled.
Yeah.
And then she yelled at her for using a prong.
Right. Of course. So she's just miserable with her life.
Yeah.
She's
happy people don't do that shit.
Right. Nice people don't do that stuff. She's not a happy person. She's just not a happy person. Next.
Thomas said, it's Finland, Jeff, with the saunas.
Oh, thank you. I knew it was one of those countries. You know what? I'm trying to think, where was I? I was at a home show. Because I used to do, so here's a tip for dog trainers.
Here we go.
You want to increase your business? Stop setting up booths at pet shows. Go to flower shows, home shows, RV shows. Don't go to pet shows. So if you have a dog training service, don't go to a pet show. Go to a home show, an RV show, a flower show, or any other show that you can do that has got thousands and thousands of local people, all right? Unless you're doing mail order. But don't do pet shows. Next.
Michael, sup guy, love your videos. Do you recommend a dog being fixed?
I believe in personal freedom of choice for both females and for animals. Next.
JP, I like the inspiration quotes on Twitter recently, Jeff.
Joelle forced me to do them. She didn't force me to do them.
I'll take credit. He comes up with all these one-liners. Yeah. I'm like, put this shit on Twitter.
Yeah, I've got a lot to say.
Yeah.
I've got a lot to say, so now I'm going to be doing a lot
more.
And
I'm like, oh, it's such a short sentence. There'll be no typos. His first tweet. Typo.
There's two.
Did you see my comment today?
No.
On Instagram? I was like, typos and all. I give you some clapping hands. I think that comment got a lot of likes.
Did it? Yeah.
It wouldn't be Jeff without the tweets. At least you know it's not me.
Without the typos.
It's organic. Yeah. What did I say without the tweets?
Yeah.
Without the typos.
I'm famous for typos.
I don't touch Twitter. That's all him.
Next.
Brian Geller.
Oh, there's one more thing I can give you to do then. You don't touch Twitter?
$2.99 super chat. Okay. I'm not touching Twitter. I got enough to do.
Twitter.
No. You come up with your own tweets. Your own one-liners.
Joelle.
Cool. Nice list. Make sure Wes eats it. Next. Brian Gellard did $2.99 top chat.
Oh, thank you, Brian.
He said, newly acquired 4-year-old hound with no obedience prior. You've seen my post on IG a few weeks ago. Shuts down instantly with the e-collar, even on off.
So what I would do is put the remote collar on the dog. This is what I would do. Train the dog first on prong and leash and lots of food. So used its daily food for training. Then what you do is you layer the remote collar over that, and then the dog will at least know what's expected. But you still have to train the dog on continuous stim, non-continuous stim on the remote. You still have to train the dog. You don't want to just correct the dog for non-compliance, for obedience. Next.
Cassandra, how do I sign up for your newsletter?
That's a good fucking question.
I think right on the website.
Right on the website. You've got to be able to do it on the website. Next.
Kay, been doing crate training and watching him through FaceTime. He only lays down for 30 seconds and starts barking again. I've been trying e-collar for a week and he went up to 100 but doesn't faze him.
I would check fit. Check fit. Next.
Camara, hello guy, love your programs. I have one question though. How do you teach a GSD to understand how big they are?
Get him a mirror? I don't know.
Probably has no like spatial awareness.
So, I know, it's just a joke.
Oh, yeah. I thought you were being serious.
No. You don't buy a mirror for a dog.
Well, I mean, I thought you like were going to just edit there like a smart-ass thing. Like, oh, he's seriously not going to give him actual advice.
No. Like, you want to go ahead? Go ahead. Take over the show.
No.
Take over the show.
Nope. Sorry.
Take over the show.
No. Shut my mouth.
No, you could do seriously. Take over the show.
No.
Why not? You started teaching modules at the seminars.
Okay.
So how do you explain how you do spatial awareness?
I can't through like words. I have to show that.
Oh, okay.
Can't.
So teach spatial awareness. Joelle's going to make a video on it next.
See, you can't explain it either. It's really hard to.
So start doing spatial awareness. What I want you to do is this. Get yourself a stockyard whip. Get yourself a stockyard whip and get ready to use your knees and a leash. Whenever your dog gets too close to you, like take your leg and like bop the dog and then pop the leash. Or you can use a stockyard whip to keep a circumference around you like that. You can also bonk the dog for like leaning into you. Next.
Lay, I don't understand really when he goes to bite. I keep being too late with a bonker. I feel like he is like blue. What?
Okay, so what I want you to do is this. The way a bonker...
Oh, the Weimaraner that
right.
snaps her.
So okay. The way a bonker is used, so many people don't understand the bonker. We're teaching the word no to the dog. Okay? What we're doing is we're teaching the word no. That's what a bonker does. You use a bonker on a dog that is already has a history of bad behavior. So you show up to the scene of the crime. You have a lunging dog. Keep the dog next to you. Stand a little bit behind it. Have a dog start walking past. As soon as that dog's ears go up, frow burrows, chest goes out, breathing changes, calmly say no, and bonk. The dog historically then will hit the ground and back up, totally freak out, might go to the end of the leash and freak out. Then what you do is role play that again, and most likely the dog will look away from the other dog. You mark that, and you can even reward it. No, and then bonk, calmly. No and bonk. People don't understand the bonker. It's just so funny. It's just so, and what's really funny is shock collar trainers that are anti-bonking. Mm-hmm. That's the funny part.
Yeah.
It's like, it's okay to use a remote collar on your dog.
It's like interesting because like you can make an e-collar hurt, I guess.
Of course you can. Enough. We do it all the time.
And a bonker though.
By the way, did you hear that? Go ahead, take that sound bite. Yep. We can make an e-collar hurt. Why? A dog tries to bite us, we make it hurt.
Like, but a towel? I don't care. Like, unless you're the Incredible Hulk, you're not going to hurt a dog with a towel. You're just not. It doesn't hurt the dog.
I think people are free. It's so funny that people.
So e-collar is okay up at 100 if you need to, but a towel?
Well, I think we have to understand fear. I think people need to understand fear. Mm-hmm. I can yell at my dog and get a worse response out of my dog than if I bonked him.
Yeah.
So think about that concept.
Yeah. My dogs hate when I yell.
Right. They must have hated when you were married then. Right. That's why they like you so
much. You wonder where Wes's issues come from?
That's why they like you so much now.
Yeah, I know.
Because you don't yell anymore.
Right.
So, but it's so funny because you can have a dog, you can have a pan. Say your dog got next to a trash can and you took a metal food bowl and you dropped it on the ground and it totally freaked out the dog that it ran away from the metal trash can. And then you have a dog that goes by the trash can, you say no and you bonk it and it runs away from the trash can. What's the difference? What's the difference to the dog? Not to you, not to social media, not to the haters. What's the difference? Right? What's the difference? It's really, really interesting. Mm. People need to understand animals a little bit more.
Yeah.
They need to understand fear a little bit more. Mm-hmm. They need to understand motivation. It's so funny when people like make these hateful comments that like we don't know what we're talking about. It's like, yeah. That's why we're so successful. We're just like pulling a scam on everybody.
Right.
We have no idea how dogs learn. Yep.
You see all these seminars.
Because you have to be a rocket scientist to fucking teach down for a pet dog. We're pet dog trainers. There's no score. There's no awards. There's no trophies. There's no ribbons. It's like, get the dog to stop pulling on the leash. Get a dog to stop barking. Get a dog to go into a crate, lie down, and shut up. Get a dog to go to a dog bed and not move. Like, guys, like, stop trying to make it look like you're fucking brain surgeons, because you're not, okay? One of my clients is a brain surgeon, okay? He's one of the top 10 brain surgeons in the country. I assure you, teaching his dog is nothing like his job. Next.
Scattered storm, gonna go. Still gonna go do drills with the dog. See y'all on the Saturday podcast.
All right, take care.
Yeah, Wednesday, right? She's not gonna be on.
She might not be on.
Haley, hey J&J. It's been a couple of weeks since I've been on here. Hope you both are doing wonderfully.
Yeah, we're doing great. Where you been?
Victoria, hey Jeff. At the top of your head, do you know of any continuing education experiences for a novice trainer in the Houston, Austin area in the nearest future?
There's a lot of dog trainers in Dallas. There's a lot of seminars in the Texas area. You got a lot of dog trainers in Texas. So I would just start snooping around Texas. See who's got seminars or intern or shadow next.
Maria, are you open for a 3-month intern for free from Europe?
Well, all of our interns work for free. Yes, we have an intern spot available in January, February, March,
April,
the beginning of April. Internship is very selective. It takes a very special person to leave their home, possibly their family, possibly their business, possibly a loved one, go somewhere for 3 months and not get paid and work 6 days a week. But you want to change your life? I mean, people go to college for 4 years. What's the big fucking deal? What's 3 months? If you really think about it, next. So yes, I'm open to it. If you're interested, you email us and we'll send you an application. So interns are by invite only, and we usually turn down most. Next.
Charlie, hi Jeff. I bought an e-collar, but I'm afraid I'm not using it correctly. Can you run through how to train a command using this? Because I'm not sure it would apply for any command. Is this true?
It would take too long. Well, go to our two videos. One on do the place video. Go to the place video that's titled, probably it has CS and NCS in it. Go to that video.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
And yeah, and it does apply to pretty much every command.
Pretty much every command. Pressure on, pressure off.
Yep.
Pressure on, pressure off. Next.
Kibu, any chance of coming to Vancouver, British Columbia?
If I find another location, yes, there's a good chance. Next.
Kim, how do I desensitize dog to people coming over? Thank you.
It's not that you want to desensitize them. Correct the dog for unwanted behavior. So let's not be technical. What's your dog doing? Your dog's being a dick when people come over? Good. Correct, not good. Bad. Good, though, because then I can give you advice. So correct the dog for the unwanted behavior and then tell them to go to place. Step one, cut the shit. Step two, go do that. That's it in a nutshell. Next.
Barb, is it okay to give 3-month-old puppy a chew toy or a soft toy while being in the crate?
12 weeks old? I wouldn't. I don't. You know? 3 months old? I'm sure. Why a soft one? Why not a hard one? Next.
John, great hack on skipping the pet expos and focusing on less crowded ones. Worth the price I paid to watch.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's not that it's less crowded. There's just no competitors there. And you get to bring your dog, historically. Next.
Willie, GSD puppy has become very nippy. Any tips?
What do you mean by puppy? So if we're talking like 14, I thought it was your phone for a second. It's just a stand. I've got to get you a proper stand.
That's fine. I'll just hold it.
Okay. Maybe you can, you know those things that you use to hold books so you can read them? Maybe that would work.
That stand would work fine, but the thing is I'm charged. So I'm charging.
That would be totally fine
if I didn't have to charge
my phone. I see. So what you do is take your thumb, stick it in the dog's mouth, push down and grab the bottom of the jaw, or say no and bonk the dog. This is a bonker. It's a cotton towel. Yep, you can bonk a puppy for biting you. Next.
Dan, hey Jeff, any other great tips for crate training a very bad anxiety dog who bites through crates? I'm doing the training you told me before. E-collar, watching from a video and correcting her. Any other tips? Trying anything and everything. She's a husky hound. I'm going to try to run her more as well.
Running, well, that won't help.
She will sit in the crate all day and not make a sound and sleep. As soon as I leave, she bites.
Exactly. So it's not a tired thing. So what I want you to, there's a lot of things you can do. Number one, you probably should do a Skype. Not because I want you to pay me, but for the information. It's because there's a lot of things you're probably missing. What's the rest of the day look like? How structured is the rest of the day? How accountable do you hold your, by the way, we're almost done with the show. So how accountable are you, how accountable are you to your dog for the rest of the day and all the other commands? Are you willy-nilly with your dog during the day, but in the crate you want it to be perfect? You get what I'm saying? Okay, a couple more questions and we got to go.
Atmospheric said, I meant the process of introducing a pup to leash training. Ha ha.
The process? Put a leash on the dog and start walking. Ha ha. I don't understand.
I don't know. I think that her first question was like, how would you start leash training?
Right. So put a leash on the dog and start doing stuff with the dog. You can have the dog drag the leash, but what do you want to train it? So we use food for puppies. We do all food training for puppies, but a dog should feel something on its neck. Next.
Diane bought the Germany prong collar you recommended, but it has a different hook. I'll have to send a pic. I have arthritis in my hands and not strong enough to attach by squeezing the prong.
Okay, so that's what the ones we have. So you want to get yourself a quick release one then. Next.
Shadow. It's strange that people are afraid to thump a dog. A light smack on my dog's butt since he was a puppy is honestly one of the best training tools I had.
Yep. Everybody does it.
Go figure.
Oh my God, you're hitting your dog. It's like, you've never hit your dog before? Give me a fucking break. I would love, all these haters out there, I would love to go to their, I wouldn't love to go to their houses, but I would love to see 24 hours in their day with them interacting with their dog. Don't tell me you don't correct your dog.
Yep.
Or let me see you with a client's dog. Let me see you work a client's dog. Mm-hmm. Not a performance dog. Not a high drive sport dog. A nervous, fearful, shut down dog. Let's see what you do with that dog. Let's see what you do with your own dog over 24 hours. Your dog always listens to you 100% of the time.
Right.
Really? Huh. Then how come everybody at competitions doesn't score 100? Why is that? Next.
True story. Kara, my dog bumps my hand with her nose over and over when I lead her out of her kennel, the prong and leash to take outside. She's very excited. I've been correcting, assuming pushiness. Thoughts?
What is the behavior?
Bumping her nose over and over when she's coming out of the kennel.
Remote collar. All right, guys. Remote collar, back the dog up. And you're probably not bumping it hard enough. Slam the door right in the dog's face. All right, guys. We got to go. It's already an hour and a half up. Someone says the contact us page doesn't work on the website. I get contacts every day. I know they're probably doing an update tonight, so that could be it. So they're updating the website tonight, so that might have something to do with it. But I get contact forms in all the time. But I'll have Amanda check on that. All right? All right. Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training. This is Joelle. Thank you all so much. We'll see you Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye.